Punta Gorda town, and we're gonna get some breakfast at Lila's Bistro.
And then afterwards, we're gonna be touring Belize's Creole Museum and Culture House.
And we are gonna be hosted by none other than Mr. Franz Vernon. You know, this is the son of Mrs. Lila Vernon, the great Creole artist. And oh man, tell us, what are we gonna do today?
Well, I'd like to welcome you to Lila's Bistro, a bistro inspired by Mr. Lila Vernon. And we're also gonna be touring the Belize Creole Museum and Culture House, and we're gonna take you for a full tour of the botanical garden and everything that concerns Miss Lila.
Love it. But before we start, we are eat. And I hear you are the chef too.
Yes, man, I'm the chef too.
But the show, how you say that here, Creol? Make we go.
Yes, so make we go eat and start now one time and so I to
eat this. Good.
Let's go.
All right. The tour now of the Creole Museum.
Sure, yeah. This,
I'm ready for this.
I'm ready, well, of course.
Okay, yeah, the first stop of the tour is, you see this bell right here? Well, this bell was brought into the town, you know, by the colonial governors, you know, because in those days they didn't have any, most people didn't have time and the clock, so they used just to give the people, like they ring it every hour so they could have a sense of what time is it, and so, yeah. So this was brought in, and these today by the, By the administrating building, and it rang every hour.
Wow. Yeah. How heavy this thing, boy?
Well, that bell, that
take
about seven,
it
take about seven of us meant to move this bell.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's very heavy, you know. And it was given to my mom from an ex, from an older guy in town, and the problem was to get it here, but we got it here.
Man, that's impressive.
Yeah, and the bell, this bell is very valuable too, because the bell, it contains gold, because the gold is what let the song ring.
Yeah.
You have iron ore, then it have gold, you have like maybe like an ounce of gold in this or more.
Wow. Wicked. Crazy. All right.
Yeah, then if you notice, around the kitchen there, I have a plant, you know, the oregano and basil and thyme. There, and we have these plants here are like ornamental plants, because my mom is a plant lover, you know.
Yes.
From her grandmother, they used to plant a lot in their yard, so she just keep up that tradition. Yeah, and in the corner there, we have a pump.
Oh,
that was one of the first water pump that was brought in again.
Why?
By the colonial and the
look there.
British
and it work?
Colonizers
no.
That
no, not
that,
anymore.
That came into the country, you know, so that was one of the first set of pumps that was brought in. The people have water and stuff.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Some villages still have this in use, true?
Yeah.
In Toledo.
Yes. But they have the newer version, you know. But not the old version. Yeah, and if it's notice all the plants, we have ornamental plants that we make bouquets and so for wedding or for any function.
Okay.
We do that.
And Miss Lila like to plant.
Oh yes, yeah, she plants a lot, you know. And like this right here, this is a we call this tree of life. That is very good for like stomach ache or external scratch or grazes and bruises. You could apply that on it. This is noni.
Yeah, noni.
Yeah, noni plant. Then this is a ginger tulip. You know, and you notice I have some little one there too, because we do a little nursery on the side, because that's part of our culture, you know.
Right.
Have pepper and have different trees. And all these plants are the same way that my mother left them. You know, because if she passed, we never come and rearrange up there. We just leave it just like it is. And
so she planted them and put them there. Like
yes. Usually start from right here. Well, this is her MBE award that she gotten from Queen Elizabeth.
Wow.
For her contribution to culture and music in Belize. This certificate, that is the
Order of the British Empire.
Mm-hmm. That's a medal right there that she wore. And this is the book that come with it. It come with two books, this book and another book, like how she passes the oldest child carriage, you know. But like how I'm the only one here, I'm the one in charge of it.
Yes.
Yeah, and if I ever go to England or so, I could go in the
Palace.
Yeah, Palace, the council, the member of the empire.
The most excellent order of the British Empire, Jerry. Mm-hmm.
So interesting.
Yeah, and this right here, we have the, that's a flag. The first flag of Belize with the two men, it didn't have the red on it. Oh. Before independence, yeah, and then we have, that's one of her locks there, because she had, she go,
wore she a long lock. Dread.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I almost touched the ground, and this is a flag that we got from the country of Belize for, the country gave that to us, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because when they buried her, yes. And these are just like, this is the funeral stuff for her. Yes. And then have like little books with Creole stuff on the Creole dictionary. And these are
and
clothes
and
dresses. Yeah, she sew most, she sew this and that. That
and she wore
and that is a custom made one from New York. But she sewed this too because she sewed her own girlfriend dress too because she always embraces black culture.
And she may like dress up.
Yes. Yes.
See,
and that same suit right there that she has on, that very popular picture there, she sew her own attire. Yeah, and designed them. Yeah.
I said jabon. Jackass jabon.
Yeah. Yeah, and these are like some of the other stuff that she sew and stuff, you know, because she's a choreographer, a songwriter, a composer. She writes her own song. You know, dresses.
Chef, we cook.
Yes. Because she had a restaurant here before by the name of Shaiba Tropical.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that was like in the late 80s, early 90s, yeah, and it used to be one of the top restaurants here, you know, all the prime minister and everybody used to come and eat here. We sell lobster, from in the 80s, we got big lobster tails she's selling and stuff.
And you don't really cook now?
That passion, that's why I like cook out of my brother and sister them, you know. Yeah, and these are some of her awards that she got in. Yeah, this
broke down competition.
Mm-hmm. From the Governor General.
This one, I received this one last year. Yeah, with,
on her behalf.
Mm-hmm. Then this is the latest one she may get from the Belize International Jazz Festival.
2017.
Yeah.
Passion for music, dedication to music in Belize.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
This, now how do you get all of this?
These are relics and stuff that was collected over the years by my mother, you know. And
really?
I always used to tell my mother, why are you collecting things from her? Because you got the money. The old junkie man come anything they find they bring it. I say, man, stop buying anything there.
No.
But after she passes, when I look and say, many things are important, you know, because,
yes.
Like, for example, right there, this right there, this is a spur from my grandfather.
From tree.
From my grandfather, because my mom's father is from Guinea Grass originally. Yeah, he had Martinez and Jimenez, you know, but
right.
He came to this idea as a chiclero.
Chiclero.
He used to climb for Chingoma, and that is his spur.
Yes. Spur. Climb the chiclero, chingoma. Mm-hmm. Get
and
me.
Then. Get this up.
Yeah. And that's
scale, this is, what the hell, boy?
Yeah, those are old scale, this is a...
What's a drill?
How about leave it at everything?
Yeah, this is what they used to make dory with. Yeah, then I have a, this is what they used to, that thing with the slave.
What?
Yeah, they used to, I want to shackle them right there. Then this is our boat planer. This is used by the craftsman of a slave abolition. Them man make their only tools and so, you know. Yeah, and the toolbox is out of wood too.
This is impressive.
Mm-hmm.
So your mom used to collect these things like look at you
so,
may want iron or true?
Yeah. I mean, you want this money?
How you use this thing?
Well, they have the different types, and I have this one where you just set on the
coal.
Then I have this one you put it things inside, then it's shift, then I have the gas one. Then I shift to it when it turn electric.
Yeah. Watch this sewing machine.
Yeah.
The evolution.
Mm-hmm. Then this are like tub for wash clothes.
Uh-huh.
So washing tub, yeah. Wood. This is enough we need flour, you know. Yeah, this is for wash.
It's not leak, waterproof.
Yeah, if you notice that one, how you make with the lead jack them.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, to get like a scrubbing board.
Yeah, yeah. Then you have that, this thing, this wheel, our wheel from a carriage, they had a network of carriages and in the forest here, like Tabcoca, they bring the British ones here, they used to the sugar and the deal with the cahoon, so they had a network of railway in the bushes.
Wow.
And that is a
wheel.
No,
today we don't have that, but back then they had that.
Yeah, they're still in the bush there, or the railway, and so cover up.
Wait that. Tell me where this chamber pot.
Yeah, then they had a pail and different pail. Thing, you know. Yeah.
Boy, what's it tub?
Yeah.
Because we inherit that from the British, you know, after slavery done, well, we Creole people cherish them kind of thing because those are the things that the masters and so used to get, you know, so when we could get a hold of that, that is very sentimental to us.
Of course.
Right.
And do you know all the little cuttuments that they use around the bed and all the thing that where we adapt from British cars, under that we know about car them bring away also.
Why? Yeah. Still go around the car. What is that?
Well, you keep this is a part of the mestizo culture, and this was given to my mom by her dad. Because like I told you, my grandfather is from Guinea Grass, you know? And his dad, is the baker. I don't know if you read the book named Bekalam. They had the baker on Eve Street.
Mm-hmm.
That is my great grandfather. Yeah,
you got the baker. Street, I know, boy.
Yeah,
and the first one of the first recording artists, Mr. Bertie Martinez, is my mother, granduncle too. So he's my great granduncle. He's one of the first. He's like do covers of all the later song in the 40s and so. He's one of a good song writer and singer.
And painted too. I feel it. Mm-hmm. Very sticky time.
Yeah, and then I should tell my master, ma, where you buy anything from? Then eventually I end up to buy too. I end up to buy this tanker from. A guy come and sell me.
A Land Rover?
Yeah, this is from the British presence in Belize. You know, this is the tank where they used to put the gas in. You call this a jerrycan.
Jerrycan.
This is like most from the 70s. Yeah, they are not really common no more, but back in the days, like in the early 80s, these were very common. Like,
they have the air, man.
Yeah, like it was a great deal when you have one of those. Like for your personal use, you know, because it was only the British had it. Yeah, so when like civilians have it, you feel good because it's well built and it's
really
strong.
It really shows our colonial past.
Yeah, mm-hmm. The influences that, you know, they have on us.
Where believe, yeah. Where is Rilani, I say? Where is the famous song? Whether the question is like us.
You say, Creole no got culture, Belize no got history because we are from the 1600s.
And talk about backside.
These are all, you know, stuff and we want to improve it more. Because right now, basically, it's only me here, you know, and I have my brothers and sisters out there. My older sister, she's the one that work along with me because this museum right here, we're going to put a door and expand this whole bottom of this. We're going to dedicate, we're going to have a gift shop. Then we'll have a part for the Vernon, for my mother, husband.
Vernon. Right. Yeah. She married Vernon, she was
Genos
first.
Mm-hmm. Our Vernon, we have a big, a very good history in Belize too, you know, because we came from the 1700s, my great grandfather came from France, you know, and he came to Guatemala, then he come to this side of the country and settled in Barranco. My grandfather is the first man that settled Barranco.
Wow.
Before he came a very popular Garifuna village. My great grandfather was born there, Mr. Sam Vernon, who's a very popular politician in the country of Belize.
Culture can't done.
Yeah. I know, and so, you know, we want to make people come visit. Then could start come already, or when?
Yeah, they could start.
You welcome Belizean too, and foreigners, yeah?
Yeah, because I always have different people that come in. I just show what I got right now, but as time goes by, you're going to be improved.
What you have is
perfect. Mm-hmm. Yes.
We want to improve.
We have to share the culture.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that you may learn to cook from your ma. I know your cook, so I feel like a presence, you know. Like you still her, and the tree where you plant, and the dress, you know.
Every single part.
So I really feel proud of it, and I wish the other cultures could do something too to showcase different cultures of Belize, you know.
Yeah.
Like here at my place, like in the restaurant, in the front, I try to push, like, Garifuna culture, different culture to showcase Belize, you know?
And I hear you got a special treat for me, a song with Miss Leela.
Oh, yes.
Would I make we here?
Sure, man. Yeah, yeah. Well,
carry
I have to do that song.
Please.
Sure, man.
Please.
The right thing, so I have the
good.
The drum here, so. Miss Leela, she dedicated her whole life for that, you know, for the country of Belize itself. Because my mother could have lived anywhere in the world, but she chose to live right here, you know.
PG Tong.
Yeah.
Home.
And she cared so much for people. Like, if when we used to listen to the news and hear that somebody gets shot, they say, man, why did people do that, man? She feel for, you know, she never liked when it happened, man, thing, you know. Because I know we live in a very beautiful country and all what may happen it never really makes sense, you know. We should preserve our culture and do more things with the people.
Such passion, mm-hmm. Passion.
Then she started the Ebolite dance and drama company in the early 90s. And she had about 50, 60 young children that she used to teach to dance. And she carried them around, you know, to New York, Mexico, different places. And most of the children now are... They see me and they really thank her for what she did.
Yes, yes.
Keep them positive and keep them motivated with something to do, you know?
Wicked.
Yeah.
The language, the music, the culture. Give me all the music there, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I sing when I sang him. Uh-huh. Welcome to PG by the Sea, you know? Welcome to Belize.
Okay.
Yeah, I will just do it well with this drum, and then you could join me with the jawbone.
With what? The jawbone?
Yes, man.
Give me the jawbone, Jerry.
The jawbone. Okay. Our music is very... basic and easy to play, you know, because this is the way that when they had the slave and they were recreating on the banks of the Belize River and thing, they used to play these drums, they used to make their wine and play the lead music, you know. Sometimes they used to play all night, then the governors would come and say, man, you don't have to shut down, you know. When they play all night, you don't have to slow it down and leave it.
They don't get extensions.
Yeah. So yeah, you have to play this, so you just keep up with me, right? Uh-huh. I will play the Goombe drum. This Goombe drum is the personal drum of Miss Lila Vernon.
Goombe. Wow.
And it's a special drum. It is knocked on two sides.
Okay. Yeah.
Not like the Garifuna drum.
Yeah, this drum was basically originated from Africa, you know, because when my mom went to do a show in Europe, she took this drum and she met some other Africans and thing, and the Africa and the Egyptian asked my mom, where you get this drum from? Then my mother said, this drum have been playing in Belize for centuries on the banks of the Belize River. Then they said, oh, okay, and then they say, well, we have the link and have something in common.
Right. Yeah. And that's turtle shell.
Yes. Yeah, and that's turtle shell. That's a traditional African music. All right, so we're going to sing Welcome to Belize by the Sea, you know. I will play this drum and I will lead the song. All right, all right.
Okay.
Welcome to Belize by the sea, PG Tamitum, so don't you mess around. Nobody could get me away from ya. I love this place, so oh dear, cause I know live in fear. Nobody could get me away from ya. And I have the rice and beans, the fufu and the green. The cashew wine make me feel so fine. The rich sea we drink make you stop and think. A healthy body makes a healthy mind. Belize by the sea, where the wind blows so free. Anywhere you turn, you see coconut tree. I feel so very proud that I can sing out loud. Belize that is the best place to be. And I may rice and beans, my fofo and my greens. The cashew wine make me feel so fine. The rich sea we drink make you stop and think. A healthy body makes a healthy mind. Belize by the sea, where the wind blows so free. Anywhere you turn, you see coconut tea. I feel so very proud that I can sing out loud. Belize that the best place for me. Mr. Tourist, come and see, and I know you will agree. This place is just like paradise. So listen to me advice, and don't even think twice. Welcome to Belize by the sea. Diga bolo peini la rubeya. Ben, benido a punta. Kim, match nits, te punto. Welcome to Belize.
Hey, and with that, you're Belize,
make we go.
Yeah.